Robert Ballou put on one heck of a show there. With a couple of laps, Robert started to come back on the top side of the racetrack, and you had to change your line. How comfortable were you with you moving back to the top side of the racetrack?
I was really okay in 3 and 4, but 1 and 2 was really treacherous. I was pretty tight. And, that's obviously what got me the lead there. He got tight over there in 1 and 2 and biked it. And, just trying to pin myself between lap cars, I figured he was probably better than I was over there. And probably coming back to him, I didn't feel real great those last few laps. But just trying to keep the lap cars down underneath me and make it really hard for him to have an angle to slide me. And sometimes, I don't know if we're the best car. He was really good, especially up on the cushion. But we were probably a little more maneuverable. But every now and then you put yourself in position and you can steal one. And behind me enough. There we go. Joe Dooley, Bernie Hayward, everybody on our B&H Contractor 63 car. Thank my dad, Tyler, and they get out here every morning at 7 a.m. and bust their butts to get this thing ready. And glad this their hard work paid off to them. And last but not least, can't thank Mike Martin enough, man. That's pretty well documented what happened last week. And for him to step up and let us use this motor to finish out this Western Swing is pretty special. This speaks to the kind of teammate he is to me, and our car owner, really. He owns all that stuff. So just can't thank him enough and give us this opportunity. And pretty special to knock out Oval Nationals and a Western World in the same year.
You're taking another Western World Championship trophy home to Noblesville, Indiana. Congratulations, Ryan.
Yeah, thank you. Joe told me last night, he's like, you know, we've lost two nights in a row now. I'd really like one of them cowboy trophies. So we're going to send this one back to Illinois.
Well, there we go.
How about one more time for Brian Clausen?